Hi everyone and welcome back. So in this video, let's take a look onto the stack as a class. So in the previous video, we talked about stack as a function. The only difference is we are going to introduce more methods, and here we will talk about stack as a class. So in the constructor, we will initialize the count and our items as an empty object, right? And now we will have the same methods push, which will just put the value onto this count as a key, will increase the count. Pop will check if it is empty, so we will have an empty method. Empty method will just check the count length. If this dot count equal to 0 means no element exists, that means true, return undefined. Otherwise we will decrease the count first, then we will return the count value, we will delete that property and return the result. Peep will just check, peep will just return the topmost value. Topmost value means whatever the count we have is, just decrease the index by -1, because index starts from 0 to n, and then return that element is empty. Size, all these methods are kind of same. So this is the same implementation whatever we have written with just a simple stack function. It is just a class and with a constructor. Constructor initializes this stack object and the count, and then we are just doing a push pop operations. Okay, so consider that if I wanted to do the same thing with a simple array, right? How we can do it? So I will just modify this function stack using array, right? So what I will do is I will have the items. So you know the JavaScript array, I will talk about it. So in JavaScript array, like const x is there, and the value inside this is something like this, right? So JavaScript itself provide few utility methods, which is like push, pop. All these methods we will use here to implement stack using array in JavaScript. Like if you do dot push, it will automatically add the element here. If you do pop, then it will remove the element from here. So we'll use those utility methods only. So this is our constructor. Here we can just talk about push, and you are just sending some value to this. So how you can push this dot items dot push, this is a method, and I'm just adding a new value to it. Similarly, we have a pop function. Pop function, here we have to return something, I mean whatever the topmost value we have, this dot items dot pop. So it will remove the element in the FIFO pattern. Now we have methods like peak. Peak will just return the topmost value. So here, return this dot items, and we will just first check what is the length. This dot items dot length, and just do -1. Based on index and return that element. And we can have other methods like is empty, which will just check the length of an array, return this dot item dot length, this dot item dot length, okay. Similarly, we have other methods which is toString. If you want to stringify and print all the values which are there in the string, so what we can do is return this dot items dot toString. This is a method which will stringify. Okay, so this is simple with the help of array. We don't need to use the object and all, because array has this push and pop method already available. So push will add the value, pop will extract out the latest pushed value from the array. Okay, so this is a basic implementation of stack. Now what we will do is we will take a look onto some coding problems which you can solve you with the help of stack data structure, and then we will also take a look on stack with array, stack with linked list, stack with queue. But before that, you need to understand what is linked list, what is queue.